Dear learners, previously we have discussed about gaseous state of matter. In this session, our focus will be on solid state of matter. When we were discussing about various states of matter, then we have seen the difference in certain physical properties between solid, liquid and gases. The basic property regarding their shape and volume is the criteria to highlight. When it comes about liquid and gases, we have seen that the liquid and gases won't have a particular shape or volume. They will occupy shape of container as well as volume of container in which you are placing it. But that is not true in case of solid. When we are observing solid, then we have seen that all the particles in your solid are in close proximity to with one another. They are tightly packed together. And thereby, when you are keeping that solid into contact with one another, they will have their own shape. They will not occupy to the mass, volume and shape of container in which you are placing it. And the tight arrangement of that individual particle giving a high density to the solid material, which is not observed in case of liquid as well as in gases. So, the differentiating case with the solid in comparison with liquid and gases is about their shape, mass and volume. They will have their own shape, mass and volume, giving the packing arrangement with the high density. The individual particle, as the individual particle are strongly held together by some kind of intermolecular attraction. There are some kind of strong chemical forces which are not allowing individual particle to move that much proximity. So, the attraction between the individual molecule in case of solid is much higher than your gases and liquid. So, the solids have higher proportion of attraction than liquid and much higher than gases. The attraction between individual atom or molecule that constitutes a solid is on high comparison, and thereby the strong intermolecular attraction hold every atom or molecule tightly, reducing the intermolecular distance. So the intermolecular distance between two particle is very short, but the intermolecular attraction makes it a strong one, and this is the reason that they will not have that much amount of vibrations. They will not have that much amount of displacement comparative to liquid and gases. When we are discussing about the packing arrangement, then the electron of each atom, the particle which constitutes a solid state, the electron of that each atom are constantly in motion. But when we are saying that they are constantly in motion, then it obviously that they are having very low kinetic energy because they are tightly held together. Their packing arrangement is so strong that the distance between two particles is much shorter, not allowing them to vibrate in that much proportion comparative to your liquids and gases. So they will vibrate about their mean position. As you are observing that the red colored particles are vibrating, but they are vibrating about their mean position. As we have seen in kinetic molecular theory of gases, at that point we have seen that the gases are in rapid random motion, having high proportion of kinetic energy, and that is not true in case of solids. So solids vibrate along their mean position in a small proportion with a very low kinetic energy. Next thing, we will discuss about the classification of solid. Basically, solids are classified in the three major classes, which are again subdivided into different classes. We will see that one by one. The first thing is the solids are basically classified on the basis of arrangement. They are classified on the basis of bond which holds every particle together. And the thirdly, they are classified on the basis of various physical properties. We will discuss one by one. The first one, the solids are classified on the basis of arrangement. And based on the arrangement, they are basically classified into two subclasses, crystalline arrangement and amorphous arrangement. The crystalline form is again subdivided into polymorphs and solvates. When it comes about crystalline, then they are the type of solids which are characterized by definite geometric shape. The individual constituent, as in on your display, you are observing the definite shape. Every particle is in a fixed position. So that will give a definite geometric shape. And when you are observing a single proportion out of that individual solid, then the single constituting atom, particle or molecule of that solid will have the shape which is responsible to form a shape of individual solid. So as you are observing, in case of crystalline state, they are having definite arrangement. But when it comes about amorphous form, this class is not arranged in a fixed proportion. They are arranged randomly in disordered structure. So in comparison to crystalline one, crystallines are having a definite shape, whereas they are arranged in definite proportion, whereas crystalline materials are arranged randomly. And after short range of order, they will undergo breakdown. The crystalline form is again divided into two subclasses, that is your polymorphs and solvates. Polymorphs are the crystalline solids which show different crystalline forms for same chemical composition. So if you are having individual constituent in case of crystalline, the individual constituent is again available in different forms, means the composition will remain same and the structure will alter. That will give you polymorphs. When it comes about solvates, the solvates are molecular complexes that has incorporated the crystallizing solvent within your crystal lattice. So as you are observing the definite arrangement, when a particular liquid or crystallizing solvent is incorporated within two particles, then they will be termed as solvates. And when the crystallizing solvent is your water, they are referred as hydrates. The next class of your solid is on the basis of bonds. The basic bonds which are responsible to hold your solid are the metallic, ionic, covalent and molecular. Based on the nature of bonds, solid may be classified in the order of decreasing strength. Means as you are going from metallic to molecular, the strength between them, or when you are observing each class, the strength of each class will vary. Now we will discuss about metallic solids. The metallic crystalline solids features atoms which are tightly held together by metallic bonds, and these metallic bonds are electromagnetic in nature. These bonds gives metallic crystalline structure their distinctive qualities. So whatever the qualities, like your ductileness, like they are being malleable and they are strong conductors of heat and electricity. And the basic reason is the bond between them. That is, the bond which are electromagnetic in nature in case of metallic solids allows them to be a strong conductor of heat and electricity, and thereby they have a cubic closed packed or hexagonal closed packed unit cell. The common example of metallic solids are like your zinc and iron. When it comes about ionic solids, in this type of solid, the individual constituents are ions. Means your solid is made up of ions, and these ions are held together by electrostatic force of attraction. And because of this electrostatic force of attraction, they maintain overall electro neutrality. Means your ionic solid shows overall electro neutrality. These ionic crystalline solids are composed of positive and negative ions, and these are held together by ion-ion attraction. These ion-ion attraction allowing them to develop a strong forces between ions. Ionic crystalline solids are known for their high melting points. So in contrast to metallic solids, your ionic solids are much harder and they are having high melting points. And they are available in three basic forms as trigonal holes, tetrahedral holes and octahedral holes. The common example for ionic solid includes sodium chloride, magnesium oxide and calcium fluorides. In case of covalent solids, they are also known as valence or atomic solids, and the constituent which holds them together are the covalent linkages, or they are also held together by van der Waals forces between the layers. The atomic crystalline solid consists of atoms that are held together by dispersion. These are solids which are soft and poor electrical and thermal conductors, and as they are being a soft one, they are having low melting points. In contrast, the molecular crystalline solids are composed of molecules which are held together by dispersion, or you can say they are held together by London's forces. In the same way, along with London's forces, you will observe dipole-dipole interaction and hydrogen bonding between inter-particle forces. These are all intermolecular forces, and which are considerably weaker than electromolecular forces. The electromolecular forces, such as your ionic bonds, so they are much weaker than your intramolecular forces, and creating them a poor electrical and thermal conductors as like your covalent solids. But as the intermolecular forces are considerably weaker, the molecular crystalline solids are fairly soft, having low to moderate melting points. The common examples for molecular solids include ice and dry ice like your CO2. The next class to classify your solid is on the basis of physical properties. Based on the physical properties, your solids are classified as anisotropic solids and isotropic solids. Let's see what is meant by anisotropic and isotropic. Anisotropic solids are the substances in which magnitude of physical property, the physical properties like your refractive index, their strength, their conductivities, etc. So the magnitude of physical property changes with direction in case of anisotropic. And the phenomenon of having physical properties different in different direction is known as anisotropy, and thus, as it shows different physical properties in various direction, these solids are known as anisotropic substances. For example, when you are allowing light ray to enter into anisotropic substance, that light ray which is traveling into the same direction will split into two separate components, and these two splitted components will travel with different velocities. Means their physical property, velocity, their path is changing along with the direction. The next class is your isotropic. Iso means same. So these are the substances which exhibit same value of any property in all direction. And to this phenomenon, we are referring as isotropy. That is a phenomenon having same physical properties in all direction. Thereby, the solids which shows isotropy are known as isotropic substances. So this was about solid state of matter. Thank you.